What are some horrifying things to consider when thinking about aliens? What if there really is valuable information to be gained from anal probes? Then the porn industry would be well informed. What are you doing, stepbro? Colonoscopy. The possibility of them already knowing about us but us not knowing about them. We have no idea if they know. They could be committing space espionage right now, and we wouldn't know about it. It's possible that they are fat single-cell organisms just loafing around. They're already here, just like, chilling on our eyebrows and shit drinking mini space tennis. Our human concepts of morality and empathy are heavily influenced by our mammalian biology. Imagine that aliens land, and instead of having nice little family units, their species lays clutches of thousands of eggs at a time. They don't form strong bonds. Life is essentially expendable for them. They see us weeping over a dead child and they have literally no frame of reference for understanding why this would be upsetting. I'm not saying all aliens will be like this, but some definitely could be. One theory, from Stephen Hawking, is that if they are sufficiently advanced, that aliens may treat us like ants. When we build dams, we don't worry about whether or not a dam will cause an anthill to be flooded out. Similarly, a species that is advanced as far beyond us as we are beyond ants might seek to alter our planet or even our solar system to their advantage without giving consideration to what may happen to us. Like to make way for a hyperspace bypass? They might be sexy, and they might be horny. For all we know, aliens might not be the little green men that fly around in flying saucers and destroy us with laser beams. They could be an interstellar pathogen that show up one day and silently and effortless kills us all without warning. Our immune systems would have no idea what hit them. There was a book called Blindsight that explores a cool idea of aliens, where they're not your typical little green men. The premise is pretty much, what if humanity is unique? What if intelligent life is common, but sentience is not? That music, art, literature is a uniquely human trait. That space is filled with cold, emotionless, genius life. To me, that idea is kinda horrifying. At least, I think that's what the book was about. I'm not the best reader, lol. That they cold been here the entire time, playing Farmville with us. We are so sorry. We can't protect you anymore. Reminds me of the Protheans in Mass Effect. Hey, here are these plans for a weapons that we and several civilizations before us have worked on. It's your only hope in stopping the galaxy-ending threat. By the way, we all died, and so did all the other races. Good luck. They might bully you. Earth is just the nerdy new kid in school. The assumption that they come in groups in some flying saucer. For all we know, they might just appear in hordes of thousands, if not millions, all across the planet. Also, we like to think that aliens will share the same way of thinking as humans, that is reasoning, emotions, etc. But the only reason we think that is because that's the only thing we are familiar with. Aliens might have completely different emotions or thought processes than us, but we won't know because we never encountered them before. It's like the fourth dimension. At this point, it's pretty well established what it is, but most of us, if not all, have no clue how to visualize or properly explain it. Aliens could do to us what we did to wolves, selectively breeding a once noble species in grotesque ways, transforming us into the equivalent of bulldogs, poodles, dachshunds, etc. Extremely unlikely, I know, but if aliens ever come to Earth, it likely means they are a spacefaring and interstellar capable species with tech at least centuries, if not millennia, ahead of ours. In other words, if aliens are even remotely capable of traveling to our planet, we are pretty much outgunned hilariously. I would much rather be massively, massively outgunned than to be just a bit outgunned. If even our most powerful nukes are nothing compared to their technology, then we are not a threat. If we pose a potential danger to them, there's an incentive to eliminate us. The speed of light is 186,000 miles per second. I think that any aliens that are capable of traveling light years to reach us have no interest in our resources. Agreed, totally. to play devil's advocate. However, I would also add the following. A big factor in their decision, whether or not the resources on Earth were plentiful enough to justify the trip, would be just how technologically advanced they were. If they were so advanced that they could travel faster than the speed of light or fold spacetime or something, then it would come down to how badly they needed whatever resources, and whether or not they could attain it elsewhere with less effort. Damn near anything on Earth except life itself, and that which certain life creates, art for instance, is absolutely abundant elsewhere. Just about every element is out there in abundance. If aliens come to Earth, I would most likely believe it'll be for one of X things. 1. Kill us. Religion. Belief in supremacy, etc. 2. Adopt us. The intergalactic draft. More friends for space bingo. 3. Study us. We are the zoo. 4. A search for a cure to heat death. If you can dodge the laws of thermodynamics, you can dodge a ball. Would be scary to imagine a starved, desperate race of beings that are trying to keep their world alive by any means necessary. The scariest thing to me is thinking that aliens want nothing to do with us. I don't get why everyone thinks that aliens would attack us immediately. It's one thing if we come into their territory, but if they stumble upon us, we are most likely safe. Them finding us would mean they are incredibly advanced. Anything they could get by attacking Earth, they could get far easier by harvesting it from a different planet in our solar system. Unless they feed specifically on brainwaves, it isn't worth the hassle to attack a planet teeming with life. They may have some weapons, however primitive, that might be used against you. It's far more frightening to believe that aliens of slash will one day discover us and won't be interested. They won't want us on their intergalactic councils. They won't want to give us medicine. They won't want to form any bond. If they decide to just leave humanity alone, that means either they have decided we are not worth saving, or that we are too close to destruction to be worth the resources. They're like that group of cool kids, and when humans find out about them, we try to contact and join them, but they just push us off as that annoying young kid. They'll even insult our haircut. That they could be massive. Taller than buildings, and eat us like bacon strips. Or step on us like ants. Imagine if one alien child fell onto our Earth, stomped on all of us, started whining, and then kicked and screamed on the ground, all in a matter of seconds. His mom or alien picks him up, and they keep walking through space. Human civilization is decimated. My main thing is that they'll bring a virus or something that'll just wipe us out, cause we've never seen anything like it. Or we'll be immune cause it's too alien, who knows. But until there is actual proof that there are advanced aliens out there, I'll stick to the idea that they are bacterial cells on Titan or something. Maybe all these supposed alien abductions and UFOs over the past 100 years have been alien scientists building vaccinations against unknown diseases for themselves, and adapting their own medical immunities for humans too, monitoring our progress against our own diseases so, when both civilizations are on top of it, we can be welcomed into the galactic fold safely. Maybe they just try to make sure everyone is safe and happy for galactic adventures with their new friends. You know those tribes that live on islands in the Pacific that haven't had technological progress in thousands of years? That's us. You know those international logging companies that would love a chance to just come plow over the island and take what's there? Somewhere, there's an alien Greenpeace that's just barely getting by on a shoestring budget. /1. There is absolutely nothing on planet Earth that the aliens can't find in more abundance elsewhere. Precious metals, gases for fuel, assuming they don't have zero-point energy or some shit that lets them get power from vacuum, and even water are all available in space, and you can get this resources with zero resistance. So I don't think they would come here for any resources, unless they want our biosphere, which, for all we know, could be abundant in the galaxy. /2, if aliens do show up one day, but turn out to be hostile, there is absolutely nothing we can do to stop them. If they have been coming here, if you believe in that sort of thing, they have been doing so for a very long time. They know everything about us, including our weaknesses, and how to exploit them. Meanwhile, they are a species capable of FTL travel. Wiping us out would be as simple for them as flipping on a light switch. No jet-to-ship dogfights, no magical weak point to hit, no third act secret weapon to save us. Just one press of that button and everything turns white, and then black. So if they do come to Earth, they would need a damn good reason to. If our luck is truly awful, and they actually want something from us, we'd better pray that it's something that we don't have to fight over, because we wouldn't stand a chance. That they don't actually exist. If there were no advanced civilization that can colonize other planets, that would mean that most of them go extinct before they reach that level of technological advancement, which means that we are probably doomed to extinction too. Maybe they treat us like we treat pigs, cows, and chickens. I've always thought that we would be more like monkeys to them, and they would experiment on us. I've always thought, uh-oh, this one's becoming self-aware. The fact that they could pretty much see us as inferior life forms. Thus, they could make us slaves, their food or test subjects. It wouldn't be something personal, they just would look down on us, like we would do with some ants, not even worth it changing the direction of a step to avoid killing. That one day they will just wipe out our planet without us ever knowing why, and that it will be so fast we don't even realize it. Blissful. What if it ends up the other way around? What if we end up being able to travel between the stars, and we find some aliens that aren't as technologically advanced as we are? I could easily see us being imperialist invaders, committing the atrocities we've committed against each other on an entire species, so we could have a second planet with an oxygen atmosphere and easily attainable natural resources. That would be truly horrifying. I mean, would anyone be surprised at us being the monsters all along? We are only an intelligent species because we defined ourselves that way. Think of it, there is only a 1% difference in DNA between chimps and us, meanwhile the difference in intelligence is huge. We are exploring the cosmos with our advanced telescopes, meanwhile the smartest chimp is stacking up rocks. Now think of an alien species that has a 1% DNA difference with us lining the other way. Their simplest thoughts would be too complicated for us. The smartest person on Earth would be like a chimp stacking up rocks for them. Now think of a species with another 1% difference. We wouldn't even be like ants walking on the floor to them. We would be less than that. And you could go on like that. 10%, 20%, 30%, etc. What would we be? So insignificant that no one in the cosmos would consider making contact with us? Is the truth of the cosmos and reality actually really simple, but we are just too stupid? Like expecting ants walking on a football field to understand what's going on the field? Do we not know what we don't know? They can also come in different forms than we expect. You could have an alien made of sound waves, or a microscopic alien. Or aliens the size of planets, where it takes 3 seconds for their brain to send a message to their toes to wiggle them. Since life on this planet is one big cycle of eating other living things, plants, and animals, to survive, they might be so horrified that they press the big nope button and end it all. Right? Imagine aliens that evolved on a planet where all life photosynthesizes. They see us and they're like, oh cool. A whole planet full of monsters. That they've found us, observed from a distance for the past 10 years or so, and have declared the planet a disaster area that nobody should ever visit. I like the idea that they're watching, but are just so disgusted with us, they're killing the planet and themselves. Their leaders are greedy and not moving towards the greater good of all mankind. Avoid at all costs. I love that South Park episode Pinewood Derby. I could see us acting just like that in a similar situation. wiki.southpark.cc.com link. They might not have orifices for eating or pooping. Hear me out. Almost all life on Earth is topologically equivalent to a donut. Meaning we have an outside wall and an inside wall, digestive and respiratory tract that runs like a hole through us, and our important bits are sandwiched between these walls. One of the only examples of life that isn't like that would be, for example, single-celled organisms, amoebas and such, which just kind of ooze over whatever they acquire sustenance from and osmosis it into themselves. Currently on Earth only microorganisms are like that. But there are fossils dating from before the Cambrian explosion from billions of years ago which hint that a completely different type of large and complex organisms might have evolved to walk the Earth before that evolutionary lineage was wiped out by an asteroid or the like. One of the oldest of these rare fossils is of a zero orifice creature that was about a meter long. We don't have a lot of info from life during that age, but it indicates there may have been an entire evolutionary track of complex life forms favoring life that is topologically equivalent to ball instead of donut. And that's on Earth. So, yeah. We could very well find an entire planet of giant, ooziomobus of assorted species and intelligence, who neither eat, speak, or shit like we do. Just try figuring out how to breach that cultural and language barrier. The fact that any life form that advanced that showed up to Earth without wanting a peaceful contact would likely just show up, vacuum up all the resources and leave us to die without any communication or anything. Think about it, when humans go into nature to get resources, they don't kill all the animals. They just take what they want and leave. For some reason, that is more chilling to me than aliens just glassing the planet with lasers. I don't think a peaceful alien would contact us. We are violent and very territorial, things that would be in opposition to any kind of peaceful alien or interplanetary federation. Vacuum up all the resources. Do you know how much energy it takes to travel from one star to another? So much that Earth's resources aren't worth the bother. What if their cheeks aren't clappable? Anything's cheeks are clappable, if you're determined enough. The dark forest theory kinda freaks me out. The universe is a dark forest. Every civilization is an armed hunter stalking through the trees like a ghost, gently pushing aside branches that block the path, and trying to tread without sound. Even breathing is done with care. The hunter has to be careful, because everywhere in the forest are stealthy hunters like him. If he finds another life, another hunter, angel, or a demon, a delicate infant, a tottering old man, a fairy or demigod, there's only one thing he can do: open fire and eliminate them. Earth, screaming loudly, crashing through the forest. We won't know about their existence until they attack us. Or we will. Aliens don't need to be intelligent or hostile. They could just be worms on Mars. That it's already happened, that aliens came to Earth, destroyed what was already living there, and took over. That we, humans, had been the aliens. Imagine being an alien, and not even knowing it. Not horrifying, but every picture of an alien, real or fake, they are naked. Humans have had clothes for thousands of years, so why don't they? They get aroused from on external physical things. The other day, I looked at pictures of the universe and thought, what if Earth is the size of a marble ball to an alien? I think it's called Ant Theory, that we are so underscore small, we can't possible comprehend the space we live in, and see or acknowledge other beings. What if they were like, really, really big? They might have all the unobtainium. As long as they don't come for our obamium. That if they are advanced enough to find and reach us without detection, if they think like humans, they'll have about as much empathy for us as we do cattle given our vastly inferior intellects. That we are no more interesting or important to them than the anthill in your yard. They won't be like us. They'll be thousands of years beyond having a DNA-based substrate. The bodies they use will be consciously designed and used as needed. Most existence will be virtual. The most horrifying thing about discovering aliens would be that the human race would have no idea how to process the aliens. We would be absolutely terrified of them, because they would probably be beyond human comprehension. Alien discovery would be one of the scariest things to ever happen to mankind. That they are from the future. Time flows differently in space, and if aliens are real, then they could be from the future. What if the aliens are humans from the future, but they've evolved so much we can't recognize them as human? We don't know what life looks like. Our theory of life strictly applies to Earth-based organisms. In the moment we actually discover any form of extraterrestrial life, that theory is going to fly out the window. For all we know, we could be surrounded by alien life, and not even know it. Maybe the stars are actually a plasma-based species that conquered the universe long ago, or there are sentient rocks that colonized all of the terrestrial planets. Maybe every hydrogen atom is actually capable of advanced communication, art, and curiosity, but we can't recognize it because we don't know what to look for. I'm not saying any of those are true, or that you should believe them, you shouldn't, but it just barely opens up the idea of how ignorant our thought process is. For us, if it doesn't walk and talk or send radio signals, then it isn't an alien. Maybe finding extraterrestrial life is easy, and we've already come across it a million times over just in this century, but we wouldn't know, because we aren't looking for life, we are looking for humans from space. That they might not exist. If there are aliens, they could undoubtedly pose a threat to humanity, but I think most people want alien life to exist elsewhere. That way we aren't alone in the universe. I think that the most horrifying thing to think about is that despite how incredibly huge the universe is, we might be the only ones in it. Edit, reread my comment. Alien life wouldn't undoubtedly pose a threat to humanity, it may pose a threat. And that's assuming that it's intelligent life. Thanks for watching. Do you have something to share? Leave it in the comments. Please like and subscribe for more Edit readings. Links mentioned in this video can be found in the description. Have a great day.